Hello everyone, my name is Nikhila Kaduri from St. Martin's Engineering College, working as a faculty in SMS department. So, in today's session, we will learn about business. So, basically, in this session, we will see what is the definition of business and the features of business.
So there are several characteristics. First, we will discuss about the characteristic
one, which is economic activity. So when we say an economic activity, we mean that activity related to money. So whenever we say economics, we are always talking about something called money. So economic activity is nothing but activity related to money. Whenever we have an activity, we are having two types of activities here. One is economic, and another one would be a non-economic. What is economic activity? We have discussed earlier, which is related to money. When it comes to non-economic activities, it is related with affection or humanity or love, or maybe it's related to your intimacy. So when we say non-economic activity, we means activity which is related to affections. Let's take an example and understand it well. If you are making a cake for your mother and giving it to her to make her happy, it's a non-economic activity because we are not earning anything from it. So when we say economic activity, if you make same cake and give it to a seller to sell someone, or you may directly sell to someone in order to earn your profit or money, then it would be called as economic activity. So we have done with first feature, that is economic activity. Then we move on to the next feature, which is regularity in nature. So regularity in nature but nothing but regular activity. When we call it to be activity to be a regular activity, when it happening on daily basis. Let's take an example and understand it very well. So you are a student, and you are having a pen, extra pen, and you are giving it to your friend and taking 5 rupees or 6 rupees from her. It won't be called as a business because you are not doing it regularly. In the same hand, if you have a stationery shop and you are selling same pen in a stationery shop that is yours and gaining some money on regular basis, you have to open your business every day on regular basis. So any business that is coming to your regularity is said to be a business activity. So we have completed the second characteristics, which is regularity in nature. Then the third would be profit motive. Profit earning. Every business has some or the other objective related to the profit. In order to earn profit, a business has to invest some money. So as they are investing their money, they always wanted them to back in the form of profit. So what we say, business is a profit earning motive activity. So we have finished with our characteristic. Now we move on to the fourth one, which is uncertainty in nature. Or you can say uncertainty in the form of returns. You can't say you are earning same money every day like an employment, because in business you never know what is going to be happen and how much you are going to earn when you have completed your business activity. Let's take an example. If you are working somewhere and you are getting salary of 10,000 every month, and you can say that every month I earn 10,000 as a salary. But if you have a business which has an investment of 1 lakh, and first day you may earn 1,000 rupees, or second day you may earn less than 1,000, let's take it as 900, and after we always refer it to be as a risky nature, because as we have seen earlier, we never get certain returns like we are getting in a employment. So there is always a risk associated with your business. Let's take an example. So in present situation, we can take an example of COVID. You have seen in COVID situation, there are lots of business who has to shut down, and there are some businesses who have raised in terms of their wealth. If you take an example of hotel services, or you can say a food business, it has a drastic change in its earnings due to the COVID. If you take the example of mask and sanitizer business, it has a positive effect due to COVID. So you never know how much risk should you have to take, or how you should cope up with that. So we can say business is a risky element. Then we have another feature called production and procurement. So here some businesses may be related to production, or some may be related to procurement. Let's take an example. If you want to sell a pen, you may have factory, and you may produce them in order to sell them to customers. Or another option would be, you may procure the pens from a wholesaler and sell it to your customers as a retailer. Then we have completed our features of business. What we have discussed till now, what is business, definition of business, and the elements in a business, that is goods and services, and we have also seen characteristics of business. Now we move on to the another part of the class, that is factors affecting success of the business. Dynamic leadership, employees, or you can say human resources, and having a sound financial structure. Sometimes government laws and regulations may affect your business. So let's take objective first. So having an objective is very important, because in order to achieve our goals, having small objectives becomes very important. Then the next would be dynamic leadership. Until and unless we have a leader, we cannot proceed with our goals. So having a dynamic leadership will always improve the business activities. So employees, or you can say human resources, having a good human resources in order to achieve our goals will lead to a success of the business. Then sound financial structure, or financial, you can say system. How you are maintaining your financial activities will become very important when you are doing a business, and you should have a sound financial structure and government laws and regulations. So we have several laws related to the business. Some of them are company laws, Companies Act, and we may have impact of budget, which is submitted every year. Budget have a greater effect on some of the some of the business, as if any business get incentives from government, the business may get successful. And what we have discussed in this class would be, we have discussed what is the definition of the business and what are the characteristics of business, and then what are all the factors that are affecting business in order to be a successful business. Thank you.